Feelin' friends, welcome to a whisper or thought of a podcast today. I've been so busy the last 2 weeks, I haven't even had time to look at my to-do list because I was focused on just getting a couple big things done. One of them is done. La Vie Sirene magazine that's been dormant for 6 years just came out with its one-off issue on magic that's releasing day by day, piece by piece in August on the La Vie Sirene site as well as being shared on social media. We also do a full layout version that hopefully looks like a real magazine with photos and different fonts and semi-fancy formatting. I was hoping the magazine would end up being around 80 pages, and I am delighted to say 81 pages have been laid out. We are done. Just waiting to see if anybody throws in anything at the last minute, and then I will manually paginate it, finalize the table of contents, and we will be good to go. Then I have to get to work on my novel that was supposed to have been finished by August 15th, the first draft. That's not going to happen, but based on the fact I'm going to be using a different proofreader with a different schedule, I may have just bought myself some time. So, what do you need to know this week? Just a couple of things, and let me look at the list. For those who have been wonderful Patreon patrons, I cannot thank you enough for helping build our little community over the last year. Hopefully you saw an email that went out from the omnioacademy@gmail.com a week or two ago. When would that have been? Right at the end of July, announcing that as of August 1st, we were moving from Patreon to a homemade site created just for the purpose to better serve those in our community, give them all the info they need in a one-stop shopping place, and not have to have them scroll through these things that say, you can't see this because you're not at a high enough level. That made me sad when I saw those posts on Patreon. No FOMO on our new site. It's called Maecenas, M-A-E-C-E-N-A-S. I've mentioned it in our last podcast. That was 2 weeks ago, right before the big move. And now we're all settled in there. If you are at the domesticrat level or above, that's the $3 per month level or above, you will get your own SpitSpot spreadsheet that's got all of your activity, starting with August 1st of this year, going forward, telling you when you paid, how much you paid, what you paid for, what events you're going to, what you've purchased, if anything was rescheduled, if there are refunds, credit balances, you name it, any notes, but it's specific to you. And if you have not yet left Patreon and canceled your patronage there, I will be sending out an email today to all those who have yet to leave Patreon and reminding them to come to the new site if they're interested in continuing on and giving you information on how to go about canceling, including a link, so you don't have to think your way through it. Our Spirits of San Diego trip is shaping up beautifully. That will be the weekend of October 16th and 17th. And in a perfect world, I would have it ready to be presented to our patrons for their reservations 2 months ahead on August 16th. It's not the usual easy thing where I do a PayPal button and that's it. There are lots of moving parts and lots of options so that you can customize your experience to make it the best and best fit for you. So this is going to take some doing. It's looking pretty good though. Additionally, for those who don't know, we are working with Charles Spratley, who's handling the tours, at least two of the tours on our Spirits of San Diego weekend. He has relocated back to his hometown of San Diego, where he is the caretaker for the gorgeous Victorian Villa Montezuma that we will be visiting during our Spirits of San Diego Victorian weekend. And he is going to be writing tours for the Hotel del Coronado, including one, I may have mentioned this last time, about the glorious movie Somewhere in Time, based on the book, and originally it was to have taken place at the Hotel Del. It was written about the Hotel Del with the crown, dining room, and all that, but it couldn't be filmed there because you can't have a Victorian era piece when there are planes flying overhead. So they moved it to gorgeous Mackinac Island where there are no planes or cars. However, the original story was set at the Hotel Del, and we're going to be working to come up with that December event that's mentioned on the Tea Travelers Festivities page. Originally, it was going to be a ghost tour. We're going to hold off on the ghost tour, do that next year, and be the fledgling test group for the Somewhere in Time event. And Charles and I are working on figuring out how we can include, since it will be during December, during the holidays, include an evening visit to the beautifully holiday-decorated villa, maybe for some holiday desserts. Eee, it's getting exciting. And Charles and I will be conspiring. We're going to head to Paris in a cup next week if they'll take us to have a tete-a-tete tea and brainstorming session to go over some of the fun ideas for the next year. Our September 18th Twilight Tea and tour of the beautiful local memorial park with Charles is sold out, and we have 9 spots left for our Lord of the Rings celebration at the end of September, Sunday the 26th. Just 9 spots left, so get them while you can. For those of you who are not sure how or where to find La Vie Sirene magazine, I will be sending out a news brief email today to our patrons with information on how to cancel Patreon and all that, and it will include a link to La Vie Sirene. And if I'm smart, I will put a link in this podcast as well. Our wonderful, beloved chapter and verse commentators, Trish and Brad Miller, are back at it and have 2 new commentary videos on Peyton Drake's Omni Tale. One of those commentaries is available right now. The other one releases in a few days, I believe. That is pretty exciting. If anyone at the stipend level or above wants to go to Murder in the Family at the Westminster Playhouse this weekend with me, tickets are only $18, let me know. Additionally, if you'd like to attend Noises Off at the Long Beach Playhouse on September 10th, let me know. We're still working on when and how we can go to Babouche for a belly dancing dinner in San Pedro. That one's taking a while, unfortunately. Finally, if you've wondered how to go about submitting something to one of our anthologies, we're now working on our next anthology called The Hours. Actually, it's called Hours in Prose and Verse. Everybody picks 1 hour of the day to write about. I chose 3 o'clock tea time. We do have some places available. Get a hold of me and I will tell you what we've got. Just 1 sec. Thank you so much.
Welcome.
Have a great afternoon.
You too.
Thanks. I love Amazon deliveries. And having a door open with a guard bulldog makes it very easy to keep porch pirates at bay. Actually, we're in too suburban an area for porch pirates. Nothing exciting happens here, which is okay by me. On your patron site, the Maecenas site that I mentioned, we have a link to the famed festivities page on Tea Travelers, as well as a calendar on the patron site. The calendar from now on will have, going forward, I haven't done this in the past, not only will it have stuff mentioned, but I'm going, hopefully, to be including links in each calendar entry that will take you to the specific page for whatever that event is, and that will be available to all our patrons. Let's see if there's anything on the festivities page you need to know about that is not sold out yet. We've just opened up the Witchcraft Crafternoon Hat Tea on October 1st, Friday, October 1st. At Paris in a Cup. Apologies to all those who wish that we didn't do these things on Fridays. We can't take up spots for crafts on busy weekends at tea rooms because that's when they earn their bread and butter. And their regular customers need to be able to get in as well. So what I'm looking at for the crafternoon teas will always be Fridays. Additionally, our craft artisan, Lindy, is busy on the weekend. She teaches her own classes, so we're lucky to get her on Fridays. As far as book club goes, I'm looking at Sundays for our book club. We have Sunday, September 12th. If anybody's available, I've switched the book, made it an executive decision. It will be The Witch's Heart. And I can never say that her name is Genevieve Grachenich. Genevieve G. Her book is called The Witch's Heart. And we might meet September 12th or October 10th, depending on availability. And I'm looking at the tea room in San Dimas to be closer for people that have to drive so far from that direction to come to the things that are in Orange and Garden Grove and Sierra Madre and Long Beach and so on. So let me know what you think about that. We would be adopting witch apparel for those who are game. People are already asking about Halloween at Paris in a Cup on Saturday, October 30th. Cheryl, the erstwhile owner, really the event coordinator, has kindly allowed our patrons to have first dibs on the morning 11 a.m. seating, which is pretty darn cool of her. So those reservations will go up to the patron community about the third week of August. I'm trying to post stuff 2 months out. The 2 months could either mean 4 patrons or even a little earlier for patrons. It just depends on what the thing is. And then we will have the Dia de los Muertos celebration the following day on Halloween proper, Sunday, October 31st, in Sierra Madre at the Four Seasons Tea Room. And for those who have never had Rosa's Mexican cooking, that's her heritage. And she's a great cook. It's going to be good. That's all I can think of, guys. If there's anything you need, let me know. I've got a busy week having to write a book and keep the magazine going and keep up with all these events. The keeping up with events is really tough. I think I mentioned we have 44 events this year as opposed to our usual 8 to 10. So above and beyond the events that you guys are cognizant of, our author's journey has half a dozen events per year. Some of them are all-day workshops, half-day workshops. And so there's a lot to juggle and a lot of really fun stuff going on. And I just keep waking up every morning with a huge smile of gratitude and excitement for the day because I'm just having a ball. We're in planning mode for next year, so if there's something particular you want, now's the time to let me know. Aside from that, I will bid you chérie, stay sans, my friends. Have a great week. Tutta.